So for some reason, a lot of you guys want to be able to track your energy provider's standing charges in Home Assistant's energy dashboard. It's probably the most requested thing in the comments on the videos I've made about the energy dashboard so far. So I'm finally giving in and showing you a way to do that, and it's a bit complex, which is why I've avoided it. You have been warned. Now, getting your energy dashboard to show you your standing charges is a bit of a bodge. It's not designed to show fixed costs, so we have to try and lever the functionality in. The good news here though is that the method I'm about to show you will work with any tariff. Yes, even Octopus Agile. So before we start, I'm going to assume you already have your energy dashboard set up to track your energy usage. Whether that's for a standard tariff or an Octopus Smart tariff, there are many ways to do that, and I won't be covering it in this video. But I have two other videos that you can take a look at if you want to know how to set it all up. I'll put links to both of those down in the description for you if you haven't got that set up already. This tutorial is more of a bolt-on or next step sort of thing on top of those. So first things first, Home Assistant needs to know how much your standing charge is per day. If you're an Octopus Energy customer, then that's really easy to do. Install the Octopus Energy integration from Bottle Cap Dave using hacks, and you'll end up with all of the entities you need. For what I'm going to show you today though, I'm going to concentrate on the electricity meter for imported energy, but all of the same principles could apply to a gas meter too if you wanted to track the standing charge for that. Now, I'm not going to show you the installation process for the Octopus Energy integration in this video, but it is quite straightforward, and I'll stick a link to the integrations page down in the description for you. But once you've got it up and running, we go down to settings, over to devices and services, and you should see your Octopus Energy integration in this list. Now, I'm going to click on this little devices link here. I've got three devices, but it's this one here, the electricity meter, that's my import meter, that's the one I'm interested in today. So I'm going to click on that one, scroll down a bit, and we're looking for the entity named current standing charge. So I'm going to click on that. Right, you can see here my standing charge is currently 61 pence. But what we're going to do is click on this little cog here, and this entity ID right here, you're going to need to copy and paste that somewhere safe, like into Notepad, because you're going to need that as part of an automation later. Now, if you don't use Octopus Energy, then you really should consider using them, because they are a great energy supplier. If you decide to switch to them, then please use the referral code that's on the screen right now, because we'll both get £50 of credit once your switch is completed. But if for some reason you aren't with Octopus Energy, then you're going to need to create a special helper entity to manually store your standing charge rate. Okay, we're going to go down to settings, up to devices and services, and click on helpers in the top right. We're going to click on create helper. And the type of helper we want to create is a text helper. Now, the name is going to be Tariff Import Standing Charge Daily. I'm going to give it an icon of currency-GBP. Display mode is text, and we're going to click on create. Now, let's add that to our dashboard. So I'm just going to get the entity ID there. And I'm going to go to my dashboard, edit the dashboard, add a card of type entities, and I'm going to get rid of the default ones that are there, paste in the one we need, and click on save and done. So now we can set the standing charge manually. So let's say that the standing charge is 60 pence, for example.
Okay, so now we have our standing charge in Home Assistant, whether that's directly from Octopus Energy or manually typed in. The next step is to create a few more helper entities. We need another text entity that will be used to store the cumulative standing charges. So every day that value will be increased by the amount of your standing charge. If it's 60p per day, then that text entity will be 60p on day 1, £1.20 on day 2, £1.80 on day 3, and so on. Increasing forever, but a text entity isn't seen by Home Assistant as a sensor containing a monetary value. So we also have to create a template sensor that takes that text entity and converts it to a numeric sensor.
So let's start with that input text helper for the cumulative standing charge, and we go down to settings, devices and services, over to helpers,
and we click on Create Helper. Now the type of helper we want is text, and we're going to give it a name of tariff, import, standing charge, cumulative. I'm going to give it the currency GBP icon, and we're double checking that display mode is text and clicking on create. Now we need to create the template sensor. So click on create helper again, down to template. We want template a sensor, and we're going to give it the exact same name as before. Now the state template, I've got one pre-prepared here. So if I just copy that to my clipboard and paste it in there. Now don't worry about remembering what that is. I will put this all up on my website for you. So the unit of measurement is a pound symbol. Device class is balance, which is Home Assistant's word for a monetary sensor. And the state class is total. And we click on submit and finish. Now let me just open one of those up, go to settings, and I want to copy the entity ID to the clipboard, because we're going to go back to the overview, and I'm going to add this to my card on the dashboard. So first of all, we want to add the input text, and then we want to add the sensor. So I'm going to click on save and done. Now hopefully when I type something in here like £1.20, you should see this tariff sensor here should also update. £1.24, £1.80. There we go, that's all working fine.
The next thing to do is to create an automation that runs once a day, takes that cumulative total standing charge value and adds the current standing charge to it, so as every day you'll see that cumulative sensor increasing.
So to create that automation, we go down to settings, automations and scenes, and you'll already be on the automations page here. So click on create automation, create new automation, and you'll get this default page here. So we're going to go up to the three dots in the top right and choose edit in YAML. Now I've already got an automation written for this in my text editor, so I'm going to copy and paste this over the top. Now this automation will be up on my web page, and I will make sure there is a link in the description for you to that web page, so as you can go and copy and paste it in yourself, make it a bit easier. But all this automation is doing is running at midnight every night, and it takes your daily standing charge value and adds it to the cumulative value. That's it. So every day it'll just keep increasing that cumulative value by the amount of your daily standing charge. So if you are using it manually, then this is the correct entity. So if you've had to type in your standing charge, like I've just shown you, into a manual text box, then this is what you'll use. But if you've got the Octopus Energy integration, then you want to replace this daily standing charge entity with the entity ID from your Octopus Energy integration. That way it'll just pick up the value automatically. Okay, so now we click on save. It'll pre-populate the name for you, which is fine. So click on rename, and that's saved. So if I click on back, I can see it here in my list, and just double check that this little toggle is on, so as you know, the automation is enabled.
So we're now at the point where Home Assistant is tracking your total standing charges over time. But how do we get the energy dashboard to show that then? Well, that's where the bodge comes in. You see, the energy dashboard only cares about energy sensors. You can attach a cost sensor to an energy sensor in the dashboard, but we don't want to show any energy usage associated with a standing charge. To get around this, we create a dummy energy sensor that will always have a value of zero.
Right then, back down to settings, across to devices and services, up to helpers, where we keep going for everything. Click on create helper, and we go down to template, and we're going to template a sensor. Now the name of this sensor is standing charge electricity, and the state template is two open curly brackets, a space, a zero, a space, and two closed curly brackets. Unit of measurement is kilowatt hours. So little K, big W, little H. Device class is energy, and state class is total. and you should see a preview here, standing charge electricity 0 kWh, which is perfect. So click on submit and finish, and it's added it to the list.
And finally, we can put this all together into the energy dashboard. Now, if you have only just set this up, then your energy dashboard might take a few hours to start populating with data. If nothing is appearing straight away, then give it 24 hours and have another look. You'll probably find it's working fine by then.
So to configure your energy dashboard then, you go down to settings, dashboards, energy, and you can see here I've already got 2 grid consumption entities, one for peak, one for off-peak. I've also got a return to grid energy export sensor for my exported electricity from my solar panels. So I'm going to assume you've already got those configured, because what we're about to do is a bolt-on just to show your standing charges in the energy dashboard. So you must already be using it to show your energy data. Let's click on add consumption. And the sensor we're going to pick is the standing charge electricity one, which is the dummy sensor that will always show 0 kWh. We're going to choose use an entity tracking the total costs, and this one is tariff import standing charge cumulative, which is the template sensor that we configured. So we choose that and we click on save, and you can see it's added it there into the list. Let's head on over to the energy dashboard itself, and if I scroll down here, so you've got all my energy all being used there. That's my off-peak energy. You can see there's a bit of export there as well, and if I scroll down, you can see this item here, standing charge electricity, 0 kWh, but a 64 pence cost for today. Now, you won't really see that change much. That'll be whatever your standing charge is for the day. But if you were to scroll back in time, you can see it's 64p on that day. When did I do it? I didn't do it that day. So if we look for this week, it'll add it up and it'll say it's £1.93 so far for this week.
So yes, it's a bit of a bodge to add that in, so you can probably understand now why I hadn't gone to the effort of showing this process before. And I know there are other ways of achieving this, but none of the alternative methods out there allow you to nicely track all of the different sources separately. You just end up with one total cost and no breakdown. So that's why I think that this method is the best. Anyway, I want to say a massive thanks to these guys here who are my channel members. If you'd like to support the channel by becoming a member too, then please check out the link in the description for more information. You'll get benefits such as early access to my videos. Please also give this video a like and subscribe to my channel for free to see more from me. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.